I mean, well, number one, Benji was very keen in rugby sevens.
Mm-hmm.
And like me and many others, we actually believed in 15s. So Benja was one of the first generations actually in Kenya to actually take sevens rugby to the next level and actually professionalize it. And in 1999, when the World Rugby developed the seven international circuit, he was instrumental in constantly helping to develop that team as a player with his colleagues. And the first people to actually take the game very seriously of sevens and develop a different training regime mm-hmm. for it differently, completely differently. And they were able to actually put it on the map. Mm-hmm. And by default also put Kenya on the world map. Yes, of course, given that other leagues in the world were much more developed than us, the players were a little bit more skilled. And every year it was always a struggle to keep on reducing the gap between us and them. Benja was very instrumental in always believing in the ability of Kenyans. And but unlike one time we analyzed, we realized that basically what those guys were basically doing, that they had hit the gym faster before us. They called certain conditioning, they had started us, maybe we were still doing what you might call Rohoju rugby.
So Benja was Rohoju sports.
Exactly. So Benja was the first guy. Remember we used to argue, he started coming down with this theory and science. I think him and Oscar say that, oh, you know, you need to do train like this, you need to eat this kind of meal, you need to hit the gym this way, you need to do this number of press ups, this number of deadlift, of squats, of stuff like that, you need to rest this way, you need to drink water this way. You know, because before that, we only used to drink water when they're thirsty, you know, uh-huh. And we believe that anybody who asked for water was
yes,
unfit.
Yes, yes. Exactly.